Right, so young, gifted and Brit, exactly what it says on the tin. Tinchy.
You are number one. I don't understand how you're number one.
Jessie J.
Yes.
And Jay.
And Jay.
Love and Fazer.
Yes. Where would I be if I was without
you? Couldn't be with another chick if I tried to. Would you think you'd reach this level of success?
Yeah. Nah, personally, it's not like I didn't think or that you was gonna reach it or not. It's not like you didn't think, but it's like, obviously I planned it for when you was younger. I used to watch it, I wanna be like that, I wanna be this, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. Fazer saying, didn't think, oh, I just want to get signed and that's it.
Yeah.
Everyone used to think, yes, I want to get signed.
Yeah, but you can't base your success on being signed.
You know what
being
mean?
Signed actually means nothing.
It means nothing, yeah. That's what people don't understand.
Yeah, it's true.
When I was signed to my first label, the one thing used to kill me, because I'm a songwriter as well, right? My own stuff, I believe in my own music. That's why we're called artists and not just singers. We believe in our own music, right? We have something to represent. Anyway, a style of music kicked off at that time and they were like, you know, we need a song that sounds like this. So we need a song that sounds like this, right? I'd done a lot of singles with Stargate. And then Stargate sent me this song.
Yeah.
Said, Jay, we think you'd like this. We know you didn't write it, but it's very down your lane.
Yeah.
You know what the song was?
What's that?
Neo So Sick. At the time, Neo wasn't even signed.
Oh, serious?
He was a songwriter. My record company turned it down, thought it wasn't a hit. When it became a hit,
Woo.
Played me the song and said, we need you to write a song like this.
Wow.
And I was like, actually, I know that you had that song for me originally and you turned it down and now you're chasing it. That's the side of the industry I can't
stand. Before they turn it down, you really heard it.
Telling you, it's like, we got signed to Polydor and it was mad, like, because we were bringing them singles after single and they didn't want to go with anything. They didn't know where to put us and we became like just an artist in the label. We're just never going to come out of the label.
Mm.
We actually wanted to be on shelves in the shops, we wanted to be in Tesco's, we wanted to be everywhere, we wanted to be on the TV, but they didn't know where to go with us. We just like, let us go. Let us go back to the drawing board, let's do what we need to do. They let us go, we went back to the drawing board, got the uni boys back in again, we done an Ouch video, and it got 10 million views in like a month, under a month.
Incredible.
And then that's when all around the world came in, independent, and then they were just like, we're two guys from up north, we don't know anything about music, you guys know your fan base, so you guys, yeah, big up Matt and Chris, yeah? Yeah, they're like, you know your fan base. Yeah, you just give us the records and we put them out. So we just, me and Dappy, Talisa, went back to the drawing board, sat in the studio, we done the Uncle B album, wrote the whole thing, recorded the whole thing. Same with Against All Odds, wrote and recorded the whole thing, packaged it, give it to the out, to the label, they released it for 1.2.
Platinum
triple platinum, 1.3 million records, man.
Wow.
1.3 million records there. Because I remember being with you on the tour with N-Dubs, and you were actually quite stunned being number one. How was that, getting
that
the first number one?
Do you remember that on the tour?
I think you're the first person here.
And we went bust the champagne, do you remember?
Yeah.
On the beach.
I remember like was performing it and then like at the end of all their shows, like, obviously I was supporting end up, so when I go on, I was thinking, 1 second, you know what's funny about it? I went on and I thought, wow, this is my tour, like, and then end up was coming for, oh yeah, this is their tour. And then after I went on at the end with them man and T obviously, and then we done like number one at the end, it was a crazy feeling, had a vibe.
Brought everyone out on the stage.
Yeah, man, everyone came out. After that, the day that we heard all that number one, I was in a hotel, woke up and I see so many missed calls and I'm thinking, what's happening? And then when I heard it, we couldn't take it in, it didn't feel real, like, it felt like, it's really happening.
I remember when part in the USA went to number one in 6 countries, like this was like 2 years ago.
6 countries.
It was one of the first songs I ever gave away and I remember Luke called me and he was like, yeah, it's gone to number one in America and I was like, yeah, shut up. I don't think I realise how big that is because people spend years trying to get that kind of...
Yeah.
And I don't take it for granted. I mean, for me, I just think it's about living for the moment. I don't think anyone understands how hard it is until you live it. Do you know what I mean? Everyone was like, I wasn't sure about it.
Oh, seriously.
But I wanted to go with it because it didn't give everything away.
It was a statement, right?
And it was a statement and it was controversial and it... You know what? At the end of the day, however much people love it or hate it, I have to be a businesswoman as well as an artist.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? This is a business at the end of the day. And even though I knew Price Tag for me personally was more of what I was about, Do Like a Dude, I knew was going to get people's attention.
Oh, okay.
Like, it was like, they were like, what the hell is this?
So that was a purposeful decision to start with
that. Exactly. And it wasn't even, there was no video for it. It was supposed to be put into like all the urban clubs, underground, bubble and see what happened. And it went to number two.
Doing it like a dude. Whip it out now, guys. So it's Young, Gifted and Brit, and we'll be back again.